The Oxford Dictionary just redefined bigot, because bigot used to be very pointedly bigoted behavior. Now the definition of bigot is, well, if you prefer chicken to fish, you're a bigot. And that allows them to call literally anybody a bigot. And we know that it's a slander and a slur, but there's sort of nothing we can do about it, because bigot is now, they've expanded the definition. And I'll give you one more. Meek. Meek is a biblical term. Meek today means weak, but that's not what it means. And in the Bible, it says the meek shall inherit the earth. But it also says that Moses considered himself a meek man. Jesus considered himself meek. Meek means power under control. And meek is something that we ought to have, meekness. We ought to embrace that for what it really is and understand that the meek shall inherit the earth, because it is power under control. And those people who understand their power and remain under control, they will be able to prevail, because honestly, the truth will always win. The truth will always win.
Well, so as we look at how words are being used, again, Sam, as you brought out, we look at the creation of the word of the world. God spoke and things came into existence. Creation happened. We can look throughout the scriptures and we can recognize the power of words. Words have meaning. Words have implication. And if you get a grasp of how powerful words are, then you can look at the possibility of how changing the meaning can have an influence, which unfortunately has sinister consequences to people of faith in our nation.
Oh, there's no question. I'm going to go back earlier to what Sam was talking about, what's going on in our education system, because there's a brainwashing that's been going on for generations now, and it's really accelerated itself over the last 20 years. I don't see anybody, I mean, they look at this country and say they hate this country. I don't see anybody taking boats from Key West to Cuba. You know what I mean? I don't see anybody rushing the Mexican border and say, I can't wait to get to Mexico or go to South, North Korea for the waters. I mean, people, this country is an amazing place to live in, and we are destroying it for whatever stupid reasons going on. But number one, it's our government. Number two, it's certainly our education system, the brainwashing that's going on with all these generation of kids. And it's crazy time right now. And we're just trying to do, not only with Sam's book, but also with the movies that we do, we're trying to do movies that put out a positive message. Andrew Breitbart said it, politics is downstream from culture. Who runs a culture? Hollywood does, and certainly the mainstream media. We're fighting that with the movies that we do that have love, hope, redemption, faith, laughter, all these things that are missing in so many movies coming on cable, coming on Hollywood, whatever it may be coming on. We're going to keep fighting that battle, because it's just, we can't let this country lose what it's lost already. And Ronald Reagan said it, right? He said, we're a generation away from losing our freedom. Well, we're on the tipping point of that right now.
And as Sam points out, the language, the way that people are fed information, it influences people, and even believers in Christ are buying into that and really are afraid to speak out in the way that you're talking about, because they don't want to be labeled as being a bigot, or if someone embraces God's view of sexuality, they don't want to be called a homophobe.
Well, that's once again the power of the media, right? I mean, Walt Disney said back in the 50s, movies and television will influence the youth. Well, look what's being played on our streets right now. You can't tell me that what we're showing and what we're telling kids isn't playing right now. Because if those mostly under 30 men and women and teenagers and young kids out there rioting, if they had any biblical principles in their lives, would they be doing what they're doing? I don't think they'd be out there doing it. But this is what we're faced with right now. And we're going to keep on battling this great battle, because we have to. This is an amazing country. Okay, Sean's going to tell about the movies. We got three movies coming out this summer. One's in theaters right now. It's called The Girl Who Believes in Miracles. Wonderful little movie with Mira Sorvino and Peter Coyote. We have one opening on the 4th of July week, and it's called One Nation Under God, which is a perfect time to have it. It's about putting that phrase back into our Pledge of Allegiance. And Sam and I have a wonderful movie we produced. I directed. We both starred in it with John Ratzenberger and Lou Gossett Jr. It's called Miracle in East Texas, true story set in 1930, right in the heart of the Depression.